Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Welcome back to my fragrance channel. Very excited for this video because we're gonna be talking about perfumes that have similar vibes. They don't smell the same, but they just give off the same type of scent, sort of. So I'm sure a lot of you guys can tell I'm very late to this train. I'm kind of behind on videos on this channel lately, so I haven't been posting as much because I've been trying to focus more on my main channel, but I think this is a video we should all continue to do because it's very helpful and just really fun, honestly, to film. So I am gonna have to go through these pretty quickly because I have a lot of perfumes here and quite a few different categories. So before we get into it, I would love if you would consider subscribing down below. I do fragrance videos on this channel, and I also have a second channel where I do more hair videos and then also a little bit of lifestyle and just beauty content in general. You can check that out. It's linked down below if you want, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and let's get into the perfumes. Okay, so I want to talk about a category that's appropriate for this time of year, so let's get into one of those first. I have three perfumes here, and they're definitely different perfumes. They do not smell the same. They're not dupes of each other, but they have a similar kind of vibe where you'd wear them for the same kind of occasion or in the same like time of year. First, I have Dolce & Gabbana The Only One. I've got Britney Spears Prerogative. This is just my opinion. And then we have a dupe for Lancôme's La Vie Belle from Dossier. And this is a spot-on dupe. I'm telling you guys, it smells like the exact same. So let's just say La Vie Belle. The similarity in these perfumes is that they're all warm and sweet. And it's interesting because Prerogative is compared to YSL's Black Opium. It's not the same, you guys, but it does smell similar. This one actually has a stronger coffee note, and it has a little bit more of a fruity clean scent to it in the dry down, but it does have a similarity to Black Opium. And this perfume right here, Dolce & Gabbana The Only One, is actually said by people to be basically like the baby of Lancôme La Vie Belle and YSL Black Opium. So I feel like because of that, it makes sense that these smell similar, even though I honestly didn't even think about that when I picked these out of my collection. I was just thinking these have similar vibes to each other, but La Vie Belle is just a sweet, warm floral scent. It's delicious, you guys. People compare it to Flower Bomb as well, but personally, I think this one is sweeter and more gourmand. Flower Bomb is just more floral to me, although they do have a similar quality as well, and maybe I should have added Flower Bomb in this, but I'm sure you guys all know what that smells like anyways. And then for Dolce & Gabbana The Only One, this is also a warm, sweet scent, and it has a floral aspect to it in the dry down, but more than anything, this has a really strong like caramel opening that makes it perfect for the fall time. It's very cozy and sweet, but yes, it does have a floral aspect to it. There's also coffee notes in this one, which there is also coffee in the Prerogative one, and this one smells more like coffee than any of these, I would say. Still not an overly strong coffee note, but it's there. There's also, what is it in this? I think it's like apricot or something, and I definitely get that like fruitiness from the apricot, but that's more in the dry down. But it is also like a warm fall appropriate scent, and so for that reason, these three perfumes kind of give me the same vibe, and I feel like if you like one, you would like the others. Honestly, I know that people think Prerogative doesn't have the best longevity, and it doesn't, but if you spray it on your clothes and overspray, you can make it last longer, and I still think that a lot of people would like this scent, even if you don't like the fact that it doesn't last, if that makes sense. Anyways, I'm gonna have to move quicker because I've got a decent amount of categories here. So next, let's get into a category that I love, and honestly, I have more perfumes that could kind of fall in this category, but I don't feel like they're similar enough to talk about in this video. So I wanna focus on these two because I feel like they're the most similar. I'm sure you guys have seen this one if you watch this channel. This is the Valentino Valentina Pink perfume. I've talked about this a lot. It is one of my all-time favorite perfumes. I love it so much. And then we have the KKW Crystal Violet Musk perfume, which I also really, really love. And this is one that I love spraying on just for every day and like when I get out of the shower because it has a clean smell to it, which this one also does. These are both, I would categorize them as like sweet, musky, kind of like clean type of scents. This one, the KKW one, even though it's called Crystal Violet Musk, is actually a lavender scent, and it has this sweet lavender, but not like too herbal. It's still like sweet and smells like a perfume, and it has a, like, that musky scent to it, kind of like marshmallowy. And then this one here is a strawberry and rose scent, and it still has that like musky, airy sweetness to it that also kind of is a little bit clean, like that musky clean scent. So they definitely have different notes. Like I said, this one is more lavender, this one is like rose and strawberry, but they give off the same sort of like vibe where it's like that sweet, musky, clean scent. And I'm here for it. I love them so much. I think I prefer this one a little bit more. You guys know it's one of my favorites. It's a little bit better for like going out, but still could be worn every day as well. Could totally be a signature scent. This smells so incredible. Anyway, these give off the same vibes to me, to where if you like one, you will like the other. Following that, let's move into a category that is similar to that, although a little bit different, because I would say that these perfumes that I'm gonna mention here are sweeter. They don't have that like clean scent to them. They're like fruity sweet, but still have that like musky powdered sugar marshmallowy type of scent, in my opinion. So we have two Ariana Grande perfumes. We have Cloud, we have God is a Woman, and we have Burberry Her. So I know that Burberry Her is often compared to Cloud. Personally, I don't think they smell that similar. These are both supposed to be like dupes for Baccarat Rouge. I get that they have that similar kind of like fluffy, airy, cold vibe, but they don't smell the same to me. I actually feel like, if anything, this perfume is the one that kind of like connects these two, if that makes sense, the God is a Woman, because it just smells a little bit more in the middle to me. Cloud, I'm sure most of you know it, so I'll go over it very quickly. It's just that like cold, airy, like creamy, almost sweet type of a scent. This one has like a coconut note, and you definitely get that a little bit, like a little bit of that like sweet coconutty scent, but it's not overly coconut. It's not like dessert coconut. It's not super synthetic. It blends really well with this perfume to the point where you could totally wear it in the fall and winter time and it would go really well. So it's not like a summer coconut. It just has a little bit of a coconut scent. So I would say that's like kind of the note in here that makes it differ from these other two perfumes, because these other two have more of a fruity aspect or element to them. God is a Woman, I'll talk about this first because it's also an Ariana Grande perfume. This one comes out of this packaging like too easily. It's a little bit hard to put on in the packaging, so I would just take it out. It has this like light lavendery bottle. I did a review on this when it came out a couple months ago, or whenever it was. This one, I have heard some people compare to Cloud, but the more I wear it and the more I smell it, it really, really reminds me of Cloud a lot in the dry down. You still get that juicy, fruity pear opening that makes it very different from Cloud, but in the dry down, you get that kind of same musky, like cream, cold scent. It's hard to explain, but it has that like fruity, juicy, sweet opening, and that makes this one a little bit more younger, a little bit more teenage appropriate, but still, I would totally wear this. I do wear this. I think it's a really nice everyday scent. But then the Burberry Her, this one also has like a sweet muskiness to it, but this one I would say is even sweeter. It has a creamy scent to it, but it doesn't have as much of that like cold cloud-like scent that the other two have. It's more like sweet, creamy, musky, and then this one has a strawberry note that's very prominent. It's very fruity strawberry, but with that like sweet musky element. So honestly, I feel like you would like all of these if you like one. Personally, I love all of these. I feel like they have a similar vibe to each other. But again, like I said, I honestly feel like the God is a Woman perfume is what connects Cloud and Burberry Her, because I don't feel like they're that similar on their own, if that makes sense. Hopefully I'm making sense, but I love all of these. I think they all smell amazing. And keep in mind, you guys, if you don't agree with me, that is totally fine. This is just my personal opinion. These are the perfumes that I think have similar vibes. And if you don't, that is okay. We all have different noses and things are gonna smell different on everybody's skin. That's a very important factor to keep in mind. So they might not smell the same on your skin as they do on mine. The next category is back to just two perfumes. And I have here Pink Sugar by Aqualina. I'm sure a lot of you guys are tired of hearing of this, but I still love it. And then the Vanille Eau de Toilette from Outremer Paris. And this is a perfume that you can pick up from Anthropologie. It is super duper affordable. And I love this bottle. This bottle is definitely a lot nicer and just like cuter than the Pink Sugar one. This one's very kind of like cheap looking, I guess, but I still love the perfume. These are both very, very sweet, gourmand, like vanilla, baked good kind of perfumes. The Pink Sugar one, though, I will say, has more of a licorice-y kind of note. I did not even really notice the licorice in this one until I smelled it next to the vanilla, because this one does not have that at all. It's more of a vanilla extract, baked good cookie, like warm scent. This smells like straight out of the oven. Like this one is a little bit more candy-ish, and like it has a little bit of that licorice vibe, but it's still a sweet, sugary, caramel, like vanilla, baked good scent. They just have a little bit of differences, but they still give off the same vibe. And if you like one, I can pretty much guarantee you that you will like the other one. So these are two perfumes I'll definitely be wearing a lot this fall and winter. Great for the time of the year that we're going into. Two more categories left. I have this Valentino Donna Born in Roma perfume. This is like a perfume that all of YouTube has been loving for a while now. It smells very sweet, but also like sharp a little bit from this like black currant note that's in here. And it has a floral aspect to it as well. There's like bourbon vanilla in here too. It smells very just like seductive, night out, girly, feminine perfume. And then the other one that I have here to compare it to is Good Chemistry Queen Bee. So this is a lot more of an affordable perfume. You can get this brand at Target. This one, I would say that it's not white as sweet maybe as the Valentino one, but just a smidge less, because it's still a very, very sweet perfume. And they both have black currant in them, which I think is what like connects these perfumes the most, is that sweet black currant note. It's like juicy and really girly and just makes these perfumes similar. The only reason I do not have a big bottle of this Good Chemistry one, I've said it many times, is because it is like my friend's signature scent, and I'm not gonna steal it from her, but I do have a rollerball here just because sometimes I'll wear it when I'm not around her. And then also I wanna let you guys know about it because it's definitely a perfume you need to check out. Again, you can get Good Chemistry at Target, and these perfumes definitely have a similar vibe to them. And if you're looking for like an affordable perfume that's kind of similar to the Valentino one, check out Good Chemistry Queen Bee, because I am obsessed with this perfume and I love them both very, very much. I think if you like one, you will like the other. That's just my opinion again. Then the last category that we're gonna talk about is like more of a summer perfume category, which I know that it's not summer right now, but in some parts of the world, maybe it is. I'm not exactly sure, like Australia or something. So I will mention three perfumes that have a similar vibe to each other. The perfumes I have to mention are Sunray from H&M. Very, very affordable perfume. The cheapest out of all of these, and it's a great buy. Replica Beach Walk. I just have a little travel spray of this. And then JLo Miami Glow, a classic. This one is definitely more soapy than the other two, but it still has that beachy, little bit coconutty, like sunscreen, warm, almost like frangipani type of smell. Yeah, Sunray is definitely muskier, I would say, although they all have a musky vibe to them. This one just is more soapy. And then the Replica Beach Walk is maybe like a smidge more floral than both of these, but it still gives off that same vibe. Anyways, they're definitely a little bit different from each other, but all of these give off that like summertime kind of musky, a little bit coconutty, and a little bit of like a fruity floral kind of vibe. If you guys have smelled a perfume like this, I'm sure you know what I mean, but I really like all of these for the summertime. And if you like one, I'm sure you would like the others. And that is all of the perfumes. I actually went through that quicker than I thought I was going to. I've still been filming for like 25 minutes or so, but definitely made progress in comparison to some of my other perfume videos. I can talk forever when it comes to perfume. But anyways, that is gonna be it for today's video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed it. Leave me your perfume video suggestions in the comments down below. I would love to know what you guys wanna see. I definitely want to film a perfume collection video very soon. I feel like we're at that point now and I'm ready to film my entire collection for you guys. So I will be doing that soon. Let me know any other videos you want to see from me. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.